Did you know that in Safari, you can now share groups of tabs with friends or family? It's super easy to set up. Here's how it works. To show you how this works, I've made a test demo account on my iPad, and the account is for my cat, Polly, because I haven't got any children to make a child account for. Now, it doesn't matter who you're sharing this with, the way you do it is the same. In the Safari app, you're going to press onto the tab screen at the bottom, and then from here in the middle, you're going to press onto the tab options. From here, I'm then just going to make a new tab group. I'm going to go for an empty tab group, and I'll call it Family Tabs. You can name it whatever you like. Then I'll navigate the tab that I just had open, I'll long press on it, and I'll add it to this new Family Tabs group. There's no limit to how many tabs you can have in here, but right now they're only on my device. They haven't been shared. So let's change that. So in the top corner of this new tab group, I'm going to press the share button, and then I can choose who to invite into this group. It could be one person or it could be a dozen people, it doesn't matter. I'm going to text a link to Polly on my iPad, and then on the iPad, all I have to do is accept and open that link in Safari. We've now got that shared tab, which is inside the tab group, and that means that if Polly fancies some different cat treats and opens them up on the iPad, as long as they're part of that shared tab group, they'll come through to me on my iPhone as well as Polly on her iPad. And this works both ways, as we open and close tabs, navigate between different parts of websites, it will synchronize automatically between us. That way we can both share the tabs we're working on in Safari, which means it's easy to collaborate on a document or something else while you're both browsing Safari together.